I'm at this really cute A-frame cabin in northern Vermont today. In particular, all the outdoor space definitely sticks out to me, especially the backyard fire pit setup. It's really sweet. And you can just tell the host put a lot of time, effort, and care into designing a really personalized experience for their guests. You see a lot of really cool items waiting for you inside this A-frame. So really pumped for you guys to check this place out with me. Without further ado, let's now hop into the tour. Welcome to this really cute A-frame up in northern Vermont. We get closer, you may think this cabin is a little on the smaller side from this angle, but just wait until we explore a little more. Right out front, this is one of the many outdoor spaces at the cabin. There are two comfy white chairs. You can sit here and sip a drink and catch up with your family or friends, like I'm doing here with one of my old college buddies who accompanied me on my trip. If we head in this direction, you have a long driveway with plenty of space for parking. And over here on the right, you have a slick black and modern fireplace. It's one of two outdoor fireplaces. Moving along, we'll walk through this gate, which leads to the backyard in my favorite outdoor area. My friend Nick made up this gigantic bonfire for us. There's plenty of firewood waiting there. And then we were just hanging out and chilling around the incredible fire pit set up for the entire night. If I zoom out with my drone right here, you can see the cabin nestled amongst the trees. The leaves were just beginning to change when I visited. And here is the money shot. I mean, does it get any better than this? A gigantic bonfire, a bunch of string lights, and a beautiful A-frame cabin in the background. I mean, this is what cabin dreams are made of. You also have a large picnic table behind the fire pit, so you can do some outdoor dining if you'd like. And also over there on the left, you have a grill, so you can do some barbecue during your stay. Next up, if we go up top, you have this outdoor deck space. You have one of those heaters to keep you warm during the colder months and this comfy lounge chair on the opposite side. If we then peek over the railing, you can look back down into the fire pit area. In particular, you can see there's two long lines of string lights. Last but not least for the exterior, if we take the drone and zoom out a bit, you can see there is just no one else around. You have complete privacy out here. Then just a short ways away, you have some beautiful views like this of the surrounding area. Especially as we peel up, you can see the sun is beginning to set up here in northern Vermont. That's it for everything on the exterior. So we're now gonna head in to this first area in the interior. This is your screened porch. There's a bunch of stuff packed into it, like these two chairs and bench. You have this bright green door then, which leads inside. And on this opposite end, you have a ton, and I mean a ton, of fire starter supplies. I mean, this bin on the left is just newspaper alone, and this is only mainly for the indoor fireplace. So you will be very well equipped during your stay. I also had to be silly and take that little bike out for a spin. I think I'm just a tad bit too tall though to ride it. We'll now head further into the interior through this door to begin to check out some of the rooms. To get the ball rolling, we'll first enter into the main bathroom here inside of the cabin. On the left side, this is your sink. You'll probably notice some of the tile work here, which then continues into the shower. I think it's very eye-catching, very breathtaking, creates a certain aesthetic in the bathroom, and the owners even emptied out the shampoo, conditioner, body lotion, all into these really cool and unique bottles. Last but not least, above the sink, you have this long shelf. There's a bunch of these cool figurines and characters waiting for you. I've never seen this before in an Airbnb. Right across the hall, we'll come into this first bedroom. You can definitely tell that we're inside an A-frame cabin from those angles along the right wall, but you have this large comfy bed, and then at the opposite end, you have this little seat and a wardrobe waiting for you. There's also some cool decorations in this bedroom, like this rhinoceros. Moving along, we'll now walk into the main area on this ground floor, and we'll begin first with the kitchen. It is very well equipped. This is a bit more of a zoomed out shot, but if we now get in closer, you have your sink, your stainless steel refrigerator, and just tons of dishes, pots, pans, just everywhere you look. You have your stovetop, your oven, your knives, cutting boards, just everything you could possibly need is waiting for you at this kitchen. Now on to some of the personal touches I mentioned earlier in the video. You have some goodies waiting for you like maple syrup, a Life is Better at the A-Frame mug, and even a very detailed guidebook. It has some super helpful information on the best local restaurants and activities to do in the area. So all this will be waiting for you on the kitchen table when you check in. Continuing on with some more kitchen details and personal touches, in this corner you have some very fancy looking coffee and tea making supplies, and they even left me a little personal welcome note on this board, which is in the kitchen on the left when you first walk in. Next up, we'll now enter into the main dining room space in the A-frame. You have this large dining table with enough seating for 6 people, along with this modern lighting fixture up top. And obviously, the main centerpiece is that gigantic picture of an ox. We'll now walk into this corner to what is dubbed the tiny A-frame shop. This is a great way to support the local community. I would love to see more Airbnb hosts do something like this. And if we open up all the cabinets, we'll just see a bunch of different goodies and gifts from local Vermont artists and other talented folks. You can see the tiny A-frame shop here with some prices and more details and all of the gifts that are waiting for you inside of this cabinet. There's even another personalized note inside of the typewriter for me. Next, we're gonna head into my favorite room by far on the ground floor. Welcome to the living room. I mean, does it get any more cozy or perfect than this gigantic wood-burning stove? And you also have plenty of firewood like we saw earlier, even some more accessories like those mitts I was wearing so I didn't burn myself because it was very, very hot in that corner. Along that wall as well, you also have a smart TV with Netflix and all of the usual stuff. If I had to stay indoors for, say, a blizzard or just a long winter season, this is where I would want to be. You even have some nice candles and some more books and entertainment on top of the coffee table. And if we now zoom out a bit, you can just see all the impeccable interior design inside of this room. To finish off the living room, we'll head into this corner, which has quite an extensive collection of records and your record player, of course. You can grab a cocktail or a glass of wine, make up a fire, and then flip on a record. I mean, this place just has all of the essentials to be the most cozy room I've ever been in before. You even have some extra board games, blankets, and more entertainment options in the closets. This is a 3-floor cabin, so we're now gonna head to the basement to see what it has to offer. The basement contains another chill out space with plenty of entertainment options. I would envision the kids being down here more if a family stayed here. We do have a large couch, a leather chair, and against this wall, you have another fireplace and smart TV, but this has some old school video game options. Now in the center, you have 2 cornhole boards that you can take outside to play with. And of course, the main attraction is this large shuffleboard that you can play like this with 2 players. Last but not least, against this final wall in the basement, you have 2 twin beds, so you can sleep an extra 2 people down here. Now we are back on the ground floor. We're gonna walk over to this long spiral staircase. And if we head up top, this will take us to the master bedroom. Welcome to the large master bedroom. One of my favorite parts is just all of the beautiful woodwork that surrounds you on all sides up here in the loft. There's also some great touches throughout this room, like on top of this dresser, you have some candles, some pillow mist, some stickers. There's even some more items waiting for you on the other nightstand and these cool reading lights above the bed. I also thoroughly tested out the bed for its comfort and squishiness, and I give it an 11 out of 10. If we walk further down this floor, one of the last rooms is another bathroom that is directly connected to the master bedroom. You have your sink with all this beautiful tile and a big round mirror, your toilet against this one wall. On the opposite end, you have some more seating options and some storage space. And of course, to address the thing that you probably immediately noticed, you have your resident llama here. Not really sure what I'm doing here with the llama, but definitely a very unique and decorative touch I definitely was not anticipating. Finally, at the far end, you have another dresser and plenty of storage space inside of this closet. Thanks for watching my tour, guys. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to the channel. My A-frame playlist is also linked down in the video description. And I'll see you next week for another Airbnb tour.